Chutney, why is it that Tracy Marcinko's curls were ruined when she got hosed down?
Because they got wet?
Exactly. Because isn't it the first cardinal rule of perm maintenance that you're forbidden to wet your hair for at least 24 hours after getting a perm at the risk of deactivating the ammonium thioglycolate?
Yes.
And wouldn't somebody who's had, say, 30 perms before in their life be well aware of this rule? And if, in fact, you weren't washing your hair, as I suspect you weren't because your curls are still intact, wouldn't you have heard the gunshot? And if, in fact, you had heard the gunshot, Brooke Wyndham wouldn't have had time to hide the gun before you got downstairs, which would mean that you would have had to have found Mrs. Wyndham with a gun in her hand to make your story plausible. Isn't that right?
She's my age. Did she tell you that? How would you feel if your father married someone who was your age?
You, however, had time to hide the gun, didn't you, Chutney? After you shot your father.
I didn't mean to shoot him. I thought it was you walking through the door.
Since I finished putting in my box brace yesterday, I'm going to rate my old hairstyles out of 10. First up, we have the hot mess. Ignore the fact I'm holding a chicken. 10 out of 10 for confidence, 4 out of 10 for execution. Then I decided, you know what even is hair? And we have the spiky warrior. I thought I was going to leave the hairdressers looking like Cara Delevingne, but it was a bit short for me, 7 out of 10. But then it grew back in and we have the Halle Berry. I really quite liked it, 8.5 out of 10. Then in the midst of a mental breakdown, I thought to myself, Chanel, you've gone most of the way, why not go the whole way? So we have the sexy egg, and I loved it, I adored it, 9 out of 10. In fact, I didn't think I could get any cooler until I bleached it, and the edgy legend was born, and I give this a 10 out of 10. Only problem was it looked great with makeup, with no makeup, crackhead. But the upkeep was a lot, so I started to grow it out, and when I say I look like a cotton bud, your girl felt like a cotton bud. Q-tip queen, 7 out of 10. After a little patience, it got long enough for the mohawk. I enjoyed the mohawk, 8.5 out of 10. If you're interested, like for part 2, I've had a lot of hairstyles.
Prove me wrong, but I don't think that there is a single person who looks better with a side part than they do a middle part. Like, please just show me your normal side part. You know, let me sit with it for a hot second, take it in, and then please do me the favor, take your time, take a comb or something, a brush, and just part that right down the middle of your skull, a beautiful, luscious, elegant, gracious middle part.
Show yourself with long hair, and then after you chop it off.
stop until that boy is mine. Baby, you'll be famous, chase you down.
Of how I found out that I was dating my own brother. Yes, biological brother, same mom, same dad. So a little background information, my mom passed away when I was 2, my dad is currently in jail, and I live with my grandma. So at the time, I was 14, about to be 15, he was 17, about to be 18. So how this all started is one day I was at the baseball game with my friends, and he happened to be there. I was fangirling over this boy. Like, I saw him, and I was like, I'm going to marry him one day. I was feeling a little bold, so I went over and got his snap. And then I figured out that he had the same last name as me, and I was like, dude, that is dope. My exact words were, now I don't have to change my last name when we get married. So we hung out the rest of the baseball game, and I was starting to fall in love with this kid. Like, his smile, his laugh, I talked about him to my friends the rest of the night, and me and him started snapping for a while. So we started to hang out a lot, we may have hooked up a couple times, but I had to keep this all secret from my grandma because she forbid it I dated somebody. So fast forward a couple weeks, we start dating. Months and months and months go by. Our 9 months come, and I finally tell my grandma. And this is where it gets bad. I'm running out of time, like, for part two.
Thank you.
I cut my own bangs and they look like shit. My friend Amanda came to my house to fix my bangs. She's Hailey Bieber's stylist. I promised her I will never cut my own hair ever again. Should I go shorter? Yes. Oh shit. I did it. Make sure your barber does this often. Hope you guys liked this video and found it helpful. If you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. It does help support us, and let's know what videos you guys want to see.